When Tropical Storm Irene swept through here, it took one big gust of wind to take down one big pine tree and change everything for the Rondelet family.
Tarps now cover the holes in the roof of this house in Gilmanton Iron Works. The day Tropical Storm Irene hit, Donna and Don Rondelet and their 14-month-old daughter Deanna were all inside.
I was upstairs in the bedroom sleeping and woke up to a loud bang, and a tree went through our bedroom window and missed me like about 4 feet.
And she was also upstairs. So when I heard it happen, I ran upstairs immediately, and I saw the big hole in the roof above him, but he was okay. We grabbed my daughter, we went downstairs.
Rescue workers arrived and told everyone to get out. Damage was severe to the 1865 home the Rondelets had been living in and renovating for the past 6 years. The 100-foot pine tree pierced the bedroom ceiling, opening the house to water damage. The tree came crashing into the attic, buckled the kitchen ceiling one floor below, and destroyed appliances. Parts of the home now have to be torn down. Donna, a teacher at Laconia Middle School, and her husband, a postal worker, are now living out of a hotel. Insurance will help pay, but relatives set up a fund at Citizens Bank to help with the losses. Time away from work and months away from a home during rebuilding, all from one tropical storm.
I never knew what this was like to be, you know, in this situation, and I feel a whole new appreciation for people when they say they're homeless.
Yeah, I'm thankful, definitely. You know, I mean, it could have been a lot worse. We all came out of there alive, so that's all. It's really important.
The family has been hoping they could be back in their home by Christmas, but at this point, it could take even longer than that. In Gilmanton Ironworks, Jean Mackin, WMUR News 9.